Let me just start.
Hey! Oh! Oh, you put your hand. Okay, we're not going live, so I can tape it. Okay, so,
Being a mustache, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. See, those are good.
Yeah.
The regular guys must be giving you a hard time for the beard now, huh?
Actually, it was their idea.
Their idea? Really?
They wanted me to grow one out. They said basically they like their beard.
What comes next?
Okay. Great. My dad. He's sitting there cleaning the wax out of his ears. I wish I could get the wax out of my ears.
We got a great, great lineup. We got the original jazz band. The one of these 30, we got Foolish Shoemaker.
Yeah, she has. She's not spoken as much. You know, it's really so I have to look forward to. It's shit listening to the music and the smoke. Nothing else you can do. 85. Well, it pushed up his arm for a bit.
Jack, don't forget to turn off the mic.
Yes, I know. Yeah, the mic's on. The mic's on. Yeah, the mic's on.
You know
that?
Excuse me, sir.
Corey, what have you been doing? You got it, man. You have to do something. It's impossible to do that.
I was filtered through the PA.
We do the warm up here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, okay. Was QT on your left? Yeah, yeah. I'll go on.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
I'm And if I go, I'm going to try to get you. Thank you.
explanations. All you guys are just wondering if you're trying to find out what's going on.
David Deluxe. David Deluxe, you're up. David Deluxe, you're up. David Deluxe, you're up.
I've been a lot of times, and I listen to my show, and let me just ask you a question.
Yeah.
Because of course, if some of those are quirks, we need to go to pass. Quirk stuff. Any type of quirk, you don't mind me using it, and I don't know how to do it.
Thank you. stand up. That's what I'm doing.
We're finally live on the direction that we're talking. Yeah, we're live without any intervention. We're still pretty quiet, but we're not live. We're watching the first few hours today. But we're live. We're not even to anybody. Telling that we're live on the Derek Shapiro Show.com or DEIGFTJPIOShow.com or DSSW.com. So two more networks around the world. Wow, so we're in Mexico, the last time we're here, in Mexico watching us. So that's coming true.
Hey. All right, let's do a little blues here.
Thank you. I'm glad you want to perform next week at my other show. I'm going to do it again. You can run performance there because that's really fun to perform next week at my other show coming up in the spring. It's next Saturday night.
Next Saturday night.
I'm the director for the general manager for the health and fitness communication. I want to give a shout out to Myron Todd. Here is Myron Todd.
You can find me on Facebook, Joey Troop, T-R-O-U-P. You can get all my information there. See what I play.
Awesome. You want Joey Troop? Get on the phone one more time! Yes! Joey Troop, we can take the phone calls. All right. Next up, we do have the great talented Nakia. Get on for Nakia! How are you doing, Nakia? Yes.
Gotta wake up.
All right. Well, I was on my dancers, but they got me. What track did you just play them? Are we signed out?
Hi everyone. My name is Nakia. You can find me on ReverbNation.com/Nakia or official IamMusic.com. Oh, thank you.
Joey. Joey, is this him?
Yes, sir. Anyway, I'll sing, I'll songwrite, and I'll throw a rap. And you get a taste of everything I'm doing tonight. I have worked with a lot of guys in the industry. Bad Boy, Puff Daddy, Playboy as well. Mainstream artists as well. Alright, here we go. I'm not your ordinary girl, I'm the type that you want. I'm the type that makes you think you might just fall fine. Let me show you how I get down. Let me show you how I get down. Let me show you how I get down. Down, 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 down. Hey! I'm a gifted mama, they can see me, you think me. I'm a gifted mama, my profile, I'm just them. I'm a gifted mama, I'm a gifted mama, I'm a gifted mama. Hey! I'm a gifted mama. I'm not your ordinary girl, the type that you want. I'm the type that makes you think you're ready to fall fun. Still fit the bill, but he's so real. But I think I'm not the same, I'm a little bit. Let me show you how I get down. Let me show you how I get down. Let me show you how I get down. Down, 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 down. I'm a gifted man, I say shit, I say shit. I'm a gifted man, we can see me, you say shit. I'm a gifted man, I'm a gifted man, I'm just dumb. I'm a gifted mama. I'm a gifted mama. Hey! Yo, good for my down by Diva. She's got a hate for the room on a Diva. Never had shit for a little bit of creepers. Stop watching my little cheek with a weakness. If you want, you can take them, take them. If you think you can break them, break them. Don't shut down my own. I'm gonna make the faces. I'm just a mama. From there we show you how I get it down. Then we show you how I get it down. Then we show you how I get it down. Down, 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 down. I'm a gifted mama. Hey, hey, hey. I'm a gifted mama. Hey, I'm a gifted mama. I'm a gifted mama. I'm a gifted mama. I think shit, I think big. We can see me, you think big. We can see me. Hey, hey, give it up for my dancer. I love you. I'm just going to one more time for you guys since everything's not working the way it's supposed to.
You mean this right here?
Mm-hmm.
Listen. Can I put it on the other side?
Just to do a lot of damage.
your testimony? I'm sorry that it wasn't that time when I was being a boss. You are very beautiful, I'm telling you. Come here, come here, boss. I'm both cameras across. Tell me more about yourself so you can help with other things.
Well, a couple of artists, Gorilla Glow, Bad Boys back in the day, 112. But I am music now, so that
automatically.
Yeah.
Awesome. So tell me about how you got started with running music.
My CEO, you hear him over there, he's a music mastermind. A lot of the DJs go with him. When he saw me, he had to have me as an artist.
Really?
Okay, I am.
So where can people find you?
As I mentioned before, ReverbNation.com/IKEA. I'm 14 on the charts in Atlanta for pop. And you also find me on officialiamusic.com. So you can get all my bio and everything about me. And also my videos on YouTube as well.
Wow, awesome. And of course, I want you to know if you want to perform our next week's show, Tony's on a huge stage. How do you find the next week with Tony's coming across? And I want you to know too. You want to come on the next Saturday at 12 o'clock?
I think
we might
go on
Miami, though. Really? You know how you interview from Miami on the show? What two performers are from Miami?
I think
the meeting.
Sorry?
Rick Ross. Rick Ross, I'm going to be the trainer.
Okay, yeah. Alright, cool meeting.
So if you can perform next Saturday night, October 1st, that's the first show in the movie. Do you know what
I did.
And of course, you said you're not here, right?
Yeah, and it's N-A-Q-U-I-A. So that's the K-Q-U, so remember that. N-A-Q-U-I-A in Kia.
Alright, next up is this comedian. He is on Rock 125, another radio station. This is Santa Clara Potatoes. He performed here July 31st. I met him up in Duluth, in Gwinnett County, all the way up past 85, almost towards 95. He is a great comedian. He has his own show, Booth Fest, and you can find him once a week, Friday mornings, on the regular guy show. They're crazy, the regular guy show. I was in the studio over there, and he is crazy. And he's supporting a new pair of mustache. So they're a funny guy. Vinny, the Pooch, Poochie! Vinny, the Pooch, Poochie!
Thank you. Hey, what's up, how y'all doing?
Good.
Woo! Hi, my name is Vinny Pucci, and I just found out a few hours ago that I'm an idiot. I'll be honest, that guy, I was pretty taken aback by that poll. In fact, I actually think that guy should be on Death Poetry Jam. I'll be honest. Because halfway through that poem, I'm like, kind of want to tell his death, you know? I don't know, I just had a sudden urge to lose my sense of sound, I don't know why. Yeah, anyway, as you can tell from my chance and hairstyle, I recently got my head shaved not so long ago. My friends kind of staged an intervention, told me it was time to do away with it, because I was one of those guys, I was very against shaving my head. I was one of those guys that was afraid people. You know, I had to start to see, I'm one of those guys, like, I'd be 80 years old with a patch of hair on my head, I'd still be combing that motherfucker, you know, just hang on for dear life. But eventually, they picked me to shave it, and I realized later my friends tricked me. That's what I found out. They were telling me, like, Booch, you gotta shave your head, man. You know, you'll look cool, you'll look badass, women are sexy. Instead of looking like Uncle Fester from the Addams Family. Now, every time I talk to a girl, she has me a light bulb in my mouth. Terrible way to start a relationship. Well, that's the only for a relationship. Actually, my girlfriend and I, we actually broke up. That's all I know. I'm single now. My girlfriend was really creepy. She had a lot of serious mental issues she had to take care of. She had this one weird thing where she would sing Disney songs after sex. And it was so weird, of all the Disney songs you could possibly think of to sing, the first one that popped in her head was Someday by the Prince Will Come. And I was kind of shocked, you know, I don't know why I was like, Wow!
Whoa!
I was just thinking, he's sitting there going, 3, 2, 1, okay, I get it. Yeah, and since I'm really single, my main goal now is trying to lose weight. And goal I have obviously not achieved yet, but I'm trying. And I know a lot of people have different reasons for wanting to lose weight and wanting to be thin. You know, I've learned that. A lot of people keep telling me. A lot of people want to be more healthy. I know some people that want to fit into old clothes. Personally, I'm just sick and tired of being mistaken for fat celebrities all the time. Because there's nothing more depressing than being a fat guy walking through the mall and a bunch of people run up to you and go, "Oh my God, you're Chad's photo. What are your biggest fans?" For the record, I have not worn a sleeveless shirt since that day. And it's gotten worse for me. You know, just the other day, somebody told me I look like the love child of Angie Ice Clay and Roseanne Barr. Which made a lot of sense, because growing up, my mother was a housewife, and my father was a womanizer with a shitty film career. So, yeah. But I knew it was bad about a month ago. I was doing a show, I was performing on the Nashville, Tennessee. And this guy walked up to me and asked me for my autograph. And I was really excited, you know, I thought maybe he might have seen the show, listened to my podcast, or heard me on the regular guys. So he handed me a paper, and I don't want to be nice. I'm fine before, I get it back. He looks at the paper, he looks back up at me, he looks back down at the paper, and then he crumples it up, throws it on the ground, and he walks away. Now I know he's 10. But that kind of pissed me off a little bit, I'll be honest with you, so. Naturally, like any other person, I chase after him. You know, I'm chasing after him down the street. I grab him, I pick him up, I go, okay, well, shit, what's your problem? And I found out the reason he wanted my autograph was he thought I was Newman from Seinfeld. You know, looking back on it, I probably should have noticed it right away, because as I was walking out of the club, I actually heard a voice go, "Hello, Newman." But yeah, as Derek mentioned before, I'm an intern. I'm an intern for the regular guys. I'm Rock 145, and I love having an internship, because here's one thing I've noticed, that when you go for an internship, being an intern is the most bizarre job I've ever heard of, because this is basically, you do a lot of work, and you don't get paid. Which I didn't even know was legal. I thought there was some law against that, but I found out there's a loophole that companies have when they're not paying. Basically, here's what they say. They tell every college student the same thing. You're not getting paid for this. It's a learning experience. We're speaking about them saying, we're too cheap to pay you. That's pretty much what they're saying. But yeah, I do admit, I had a lot of great time with writing that show. You know, I've gotten a lot of recognition from it. I get to perform in a lot more places. And one cool thing they let me do is the regular guys gave me an opportunity to actually interview a few of the celebrities on the show. I got my own one-on-one interviews. And I got to interview a lot of people. I interviewed Tom Bridges from different strokes. A couple weeks ago, I interviewed Nick Swanson, the star of Bucky Larson. I was this close to getting an interview with Triple H, but he canceled. But I got to say, the most bizarre interview I ever had, I interviewed Linda Hogan. Now, for those of you who don't know who she is, Linda Hogan is the ex-wife of the professional wrestler Hulk Hogan, from Hogan Knows Best. And I did a 10-minute interview with her, because she recently was promoting a book. The book was entitled, Wrestling the Hulk, My Life Against the Ropes. I'll let you insert your own punchline there. So basically, I'm a wrestling fan. I love Hulk Hogan. I was a big fan of him. You know, I was a fan of the training, the prayers, the vitamins, the pythons, brother. I love Hulk Hogan. But I want to go into it, but in the middle of an interview, I have to go in there with a fair and objective mind. You know, I have to give Linda the benefit of the doubt that maybe, just maybe, she might be telling the truth. So about 7 minutes we talked, and I thought we had a great interview. A week later, I'm in the studio with the regular guys. We're recapping the interview. And we get an email from Linda's publicist that made me laugh my ass off. It said this, and I quote. Linda was very unhappy in the interview. She was so unhappy, she wanted to cancel the rest of her tour. Now here's what I don't get. This woman tells me she can endure a 24-year physical abusive relationship with a professional wrestler, but you can't give a 10-minute interview with a radio intern. That's the message I got. And what really bothered me, and what shocked me, that as an interviewer, I had no idea that I possessed that kind of power. I had no idea I had the ability to piss off someone so much that they will cancel their entire tour, just quit and go in the towel. If I had known this, I would have interviewed Lady Gaga so long ago. I could have saved us all a lot of pain and suffering. I didn't think about it. With the power of one single interview, I could cure Bieber fever. I could have. He said this with Bruno Mars. I'll piss him off so much he won't feel like doing anything. That's the power I possess. But yeah, it's been the regular guy's show is, and I've also met a lot of other bizarre people on the show. And I gotta say, the most bizarre incident I ever had was the first time I had to share the story in public. Was I had a one-on-one encounter with a certain individual by the name of Danger Woman. Now, if you listen to the regular guy's show or maybe you went to DragonCon recently, chances are, you know who I'm talking about. For those of you that don't, I'll explain. Danger Woman is she's a brightly blue-colored superhero who's not even a bag of trail mix. Like, you ever seen that scene of Willy Wonka in a chocolate factory when the chick eats a piece of gum and it swells up into a giant blueberry? Yeah, put a mask in a skateboard, that's Danger Woman, pretty much, in a nutshell. And I didn't realize how strange she was. Like, at first, they all started when I was back in the office. I had to type out some information for the show. Because one of my jobs as an intern is to come up with biographies and information on the people we're going to interview so the regular guys have ideas on what to talk about when they come in. So, I'm typing out information, I'm walking to the printer, and all of a sudden, Danger Woman is, I'm face-to-face Danger Woman in the hallway. And I had a conversation with her that was so bizarre, my brain can still not process it. Basically, what happened, she was one of the interns, and Danger Woman walks up to me and goes, "And what is your name, citizen?" And I said, and the intern goes, "Oh, this is Vinny Gucci." And at that moment, I saw all the joy and happiness leave this woman's eyes and be replaced with this look of pure hatred. Like, she's staring daggers at me, like she's going to burn a hole through my chest. And she's got this angry look, she looks at me and goes, "So, you're the Boots." I'm kind of like, yes, I'm the Boots. Nice to meet you. How was your day? I swear to God, I got my witness. She looked me dead in the eye and said, "I heard you've been doing a lot of no-nos." And I'm like, "Excuse me?" And she goes, "That's right, Bush. I know all about you and your diabolical misadventures. And I'm going to tell your mother." And I'm just stuck there. I'm frozen in time. Not because I'm afraid, but because I'm so incredibly confused by what the hell just happened. First of all, she said no. First of all, last time I did a no-no, I was hurrying, alright? I was sick the last time I did a no-no. Second of all, I have no idea what the hell a diabolical misadventure is. Unless she counts sitting in my underwear and playing video games, a misadventure. That's pretty much what I do with my day. And another thing I'm wondering is, how the hell does she know my mother? I don't know, my mother never told me a story about meeting a bizarre superhero on the street. And I'm trying to find, and eventually, of course, I'm mic'd up. The regular guys hear all of this. Because one of the segments I have on the show is called Mic'd Up, where they basically put a mic on me, and if I go anywhere, if I talk to myself, or something bizarre happens to me, they play it on the air. So they hear all of this. And the regular guys bring Larry into, the regular guys bring Danger Woman into the studio to finally find out what it is she's so angry with me about. And what bothers me is that she's mad about something, but she's not being specific. She keeps throwing out, like, six-year-old jargon acting the whole time. Like, they ask, "Okay, what's Mrs. Benjamin talking about?" She goes, "The grown-up stuff." So we ask her, "Okay, what are you talking about?" And apparently, the regular guys, they understand Danger Woman. They can read her mind. So they find out, it turns out, what Danger Woman is pissed off about was the fact that I had a one-night stand with a chick, and I had a one-night stand with a girl, and I talked about it on the air. So Danger Woman looks at me and goes, "Shame on you. Now I'm pissed." Okay, before I was just letting Danger Woman have her fun, now I'm pissed, and I said, "All right, look at here, you bitchy blueberry from hell. I'm a grown-ass man, okay? If I would spend $200 on a hotel room and have sex with a girl that I met up at Craigslist, that's my God-given right. Last I checked, this is America, okay? Land is free and home of the mind your own fucking business." Well, long story short, I got juice back in the show, I got shot by the BB gun, I'm saying that. But yeah, I'm also having another recent report about being a college student. I actually recently graduated college. I'm really excited about that. Thank you. And as a former college student, I take this opportunity to thank Gary Shapiro for putting together a benefit show to help the homeless, because now hopefully they'll leave me alone. Seriously, there is nothing more annoying. Why do homeless people insist on bugging college students? Don't they know if it wasn't for our parents, we'd be right across the street doing the same fucking thing? There's nothing more, and the problem with me is that when I was one of those kids that when I had a high classes, they weren't all in the same building. I had to walk from one end of the city to the other end of the city and back again. So there's nothing more annoying than walking to class and having some idiot behind me going, "Yo, Paul, man, come back here, say some change, pass the brother." And we always say that, dude, like, pass the brother. It's like, dude, we're not related, get the fuck away from me. I mean, but don't get me wrong, I don't hate the homeless, you know, I understand how tough it is, you know, not having any money and struggling, especially when I'm at that point right now. Dude, I had here's how broke I am. I had $10 in my wallet. I had to use that $10 to fill up my gas tank to make it to the show tonight. Which means now when I drive back home, I'm spending the whole drive home praying. That's what I'm going to be doing. I'm just sitting in my car going, "Please, God, don't let me run out of gas. Please, God, don't let me run out of gas. I'm a saint, I'm a solid, I'm a solid. I'm going to run out of gas on I-75. I'm freaking out." But yeah, I graduated from Georgia State University. And after being at Georgia State, I can honestly say, Georgia State is like jail. It's easy to get into, but it's impossible to get out. But yeah, I wasn't a very bright kid in college. I mean, I graduated, I got a bachelor's degree, but I kind of sweet-spot, you know? It's like, everybody's like, "Dude, you're excited to get a bachelor's degree." I'm like, "Dude, it was a 2.78. Don't get all excited." I'm surprised. I didn't even know that you walk away with that. That's fucking cool. I'm just saying, don't get me wrong, I'm a smart guy, but I ain't going into finance, you know what I'm saying? But here's how I knew I was right. My first semester, I got kicked out of film appreciation. That's how bad I was. And it wasn't even my fault. What happened was, you were supposed to bring a DVD for a project we were doing. I had a release of theme. And I didn't have one, and Blockbuster was sold out, so I was just in trouble. So I went to my neighbor's house, and he gave me this DVD entitled 101 Arabian Nights. At first I thought, man, this is awesome. Action packed, bloodshed, this is gonna kick ass. Problem is, it would have been a great movie, but my friend neglected to tell me it was a porno before I brought it to class. I'm putting this tape in, I'm excited to watch 101 Arabian Nights fight to death, instead of watching 101 Ways to Fuck Princess Jasmine in a Pit. Thanks a lot. Surprised I paid for having a religious teacher who kicked me out. Well, all of my religious at all, in fact, most of my living in Georgia is I don't even have to go to church. They bring church to me. Every Sunday, Jehovah's Witnesses, I am flooded with them. I have my world come to my door, and after listening to this woman talk, I'm now convinced these people should not be advertising heaven. I don't know who this Jehovah guy is, I never met him, he has that doubt. The shittiest marketing department I have ever seen in my whole entire life. This woman actually says to me, out of the billions of people who live on the earth, only 144,000 of us actually make it to heaven. Now, why on earth would you make that public knowledge? Like, seriously, if God came to you with only 144,000 people going to heaven, is that really a piece of information that you want to go door to door at 3 in the morning and share with the public, knowing you're going to lose your spot? I think not. I'm just saying, how so when does that be my best kept secret? It's like, yes, I am going to heaven, you will burn in hell surrounded by cows. So anyway, this lady starts talking, and I don't want to listen, so I make up a little story, and it'll leave. So I'm like, "Hey, honey, please, stop talking." I probably should have mentioned this at the beginning, but I'm actually atheist, you know, because I used to be Catholic, but I converted. I'm going through a very sad and depressing time in my life, and I finally accept the fact that, you know what, God doesn't answer my prayers. I can throw this out on the plate. That voice just backfires. Al starts crying, tears, and she goes, sorry for me. And she goes, but sir, what on earth would make you think God doesn't answer your prayers? And I looked at her and said, because you're always at my door. And that's why I'm amazing to y'all. Awesome. Thank you so much. Honestly, I get it from my life, just stuff I experience. Either that or I read in the news.
Really? That's awesome, awesome.
And of course, tell me, why the regular guys want to put a bigger mustache on? Is there anything?
Apparently they were trying to find a new look for me. You know, one of the goals of the regular guys is like one of the guys in the show, Larry Wax. He's become like a mentor to me. He sees me as his protege, as a project. He's basically trying to turn me from a shy, insecure individual into a stud. His goal was trying to get me to look a certain way. He's trying to change my appearance, my personality. He's trying to make me more appealing to women. Someone had told him, one of my friends I went to college with happened to mention that I have when I have a full beard, it's red because I'm half Irish. So the regular guys really interested in seeing it. So I grew it out, and they all went, that's your look right there.
Now, also, you work for Southside Steve, because Southside Steve owns the club in Southside Atlanta.
Yes.
And you always hear it advertised on the hip-hop station, Wild 105.7. Which is a clear channel station. Okay, why does he always advertise that club on Y1.5.7? Not on the regular night show.
Honestly, I don't know. I didn't really ask about that, but I know that before he was on the regular night show, he used to do the afternoon show at 96 Rock.
Really?
Back when it was called Clear Channel, it was called 96 Rock when he came across 91. Larry and Eric, there was just the two of them, and they used to work at 96 Rock, and then Southside Steve did the afternoon show. And then occasionally Southside Steve would come in and hang out with the regular guys, and that's how he became part of the team. Eventually they all left 96 Rock, and then when they went to Rock 105, Southside Steve joined in. But why he only advertises there, I don't know. I guess it's because he has a lot of friends there. Why he doesn't promote on Rock 105, I don't know. But he does promote from time to time, but it's only when he's going to be there.
And of course, we're going to Rock 105. We're on the DerrickShapiroShow.com live, and I'm Andy Davis.
Yes, I am doing a lot of crossovers. I actually have an announcement I wanted to make. Recently, on Creative Living Magazine, I was actually voted the Reader's Pick for Best Local Comedian in Atlanta.
Oh, come on.
I was the lead comedian in 2011. And I wanted to follow along the stream show. I want to take the opportunity to thank everyone that voted for me and congratulated me for getting the Best Local Comedian Award. I couldn't have done it without you guys. I mean, all the comedians that have, you know, given me advice and stood by me. Of course, the regular guys, I have to thank them as well for everything they've done for me.
Thank you. Your Italian, of course, okay? I love Italian food. Who loves Italian food, okay? I say Italian food to my children. Hey, chicken parmesan, okay? Are you from New Orleans? A lot of Italian food.
Yes, I've lived in a lot of places. I lived in New Jersey for a while, in Pennsylvania. All my relatives on my father's side, they're Italian, are all in South Philly.
Yes.
Yes, we're all in South Philly. From my grandfather's house, you can walk to the Spectrum, you can walk to Veterans Stadium, you can walk to the place where the Phillies play, don't even know. Yes, but yes, I'm very tired of actually, I'm from New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Ohio. This is the only southern state I've lived in, is Georgia, and I love it.
Thank you, ready for the boost! 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. Alright, next, my co-host for this evening. She's the host of my show on DerrickShapiroShow.com. She's going to be the regular on the Derrick Shapiro Show. She did it along with Honey Point and David Deluxe. Give it up for Shanice! How are you doing, Shanice?
Yo! Oh my God! Okay. You know, I just started this. It's kind of new to me. But I do want to introduce my crew, Money Boy, over here. There we go. And, so we're going to bring up Coyote.
Coyote!
Yeah. Let's see what you got, Coyote!
I've got to mention, what new resolution he says, very best, is her smile. She can light up a room with a smile, right? Give it up for her smile!
Yes, that's funny. It should be even fun.
Not funny, I'm on the radio. Is it fun? All right, how are you?
Who's up next? Who's up next? After Coyote, we have How Do You Fly. After How Do You Fly, we have Money for Money Entertainment. Then we have Hustle Bunny on her way. All right, you up?
Let me just.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
I'm going to go to the hospital. And after the time of the day, you run out of the house and you go, 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 and you go,
When you're not going to be able to do it, you're going to be able to do it. Hey, when you're going to be able to do it, you're going to be able to do it. You're going to be able to do it. You're going to be able to do it.
I want you to perform next week, next Saturday, at Tony's Bar and Grill.
Hey. I don't know what the hell is going to talk about showing the truth today. You saw it, you know what I'm saying? I was just thinking that you know, you showed up, you showed me what I'm saying. And God, I'm going to show you what I'm saying. 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 I'm trying to find a whole new school out. Shout out to the Lord, you know what I'm saying? You're going to have a two year old. That was definitely wrong with your network, you know, man. I'm seeing you on TV, you know, you're showing around.
Yeah.